guys, and welcome to Media Strikes Back.
Oh, that was very energetic there. I
yeah,
love it, Jules.
I tried. I'm
welcome
Jules.
To the couch.
Thanks. I'm here. I'm happy.
You're here. You're happy. That's
got
what we
good
like.
Company.
Yeah. Well, thank you. Likewise, I have good company also. Tell
got
us.
A big show, don't we?
We do have a big show,
yeah.
And it's your first one on the couch. This is what I love.
I know.
So let's get excited and revved up. Who have we got lined up for today?
We've got some pretty big interviews that
okay.
We've done here at Media Strikes Back.
Yeah.
One of which I did with the very well-known Julian Simmons.
Oh,
not
very
Simons.
Nice. Oh.
I made that mistake. I made that error in the interview, but it's Julian Simmons. He was one of the runners-up for The Voice.
Oh, fantastic. Yep. Yeah. So,
he's fantastic.
All right. And then, of course, we've got Level Up magazine, so we're going to jump into those guys as well.
Yeah, you spoke
to
them.
Oh, yeah, we certainly did, so we're going to find out a little bit more information about them.
Mm-hmm.
And then who have we got finally on the episode?
And then we've got Ash.
Oh, here we go. Challenge. Ash.
I can't say it.
Oh, well, I tell you what, let's just jump straight into Julian Simmons, all right? Because we can pronounce that one, and then when we come
back
we'll challenge you again and see if we can find out what that surname for Ash is.
Okay.
All right, here we go.
Treat me so right, girl. Got this feeling that your love is gonna reach me tonight. I wanna make you proud. I wanna scream your name so loud. Cause you're the air I breathe, honey. You're the reason that I sang, and so I'll give you everything.
Hi there, my name's Julia Vogel for Media Strikes Back, and today I have a very special guest. I'd like to welcome Julian Simons. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks for having me on the show.
Yeah, no worries. Well, I've really come in here because you're performing tonight. This is the first leg of your newest tour, Get Home Tour. How's it going? Are you nervous?
Yeah, I mean, it's natural to be nervous, but I'm pretty pumped, you know. It's been a while coming to this, so pretty pumped up.
Yeah, you've been planning this for a while. You started writing this EP a year ago, is that right?
Yeah, correct, yeah. Oh, about probably 6 months ago now, yeah. And yeah, I worked with some pretty amazing producers and even Michael Best, who helped do a couple of the acoustic tracks on the EP. So yeah, really looking forward to it.
Yeah, it's fun when things finally come together. It's like, you know, you put so much time into it, and it's just like the final product's amazing. Now, tonight you're going to be performing your second single, Get Home To You. Are you really excited for people to start hearing this new song?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's the second single I've released off the EP, and yeah, just really keen to see what, you know, folks think about it, and yeah.
Yeah, I mean, for me, a word that sums you up perfectly is smooth, and your songs are also catchy, and this one is no different. I think everyone's going to love it. Do you think they're going to love it?
Yeah, I think they will. It's been released for a little while now, so a couple of weeks, and yeah, hopefully the crowd really get into it.
Yeah. So I've read that this whole EP is dedicated to your wife. That's so romantic. Every song is really about your relationship. Is that right?
Well, yeah, I try to write my songs based on, you know, my life. And for this EP, I was inspired to write an EP, you know, with the themes based around love. So it was only natural for me to put myself into the picture and, yeah, write songs like that.
Of course, if you didn't, we'd be like, hang on, didn't you just get married? So most people know you from season 3 of The Voice, but you've been playing music far before that. That was a perfect stepping stone for you, wasn't it?
Oh yeah, definitely. I think as an artist, you know, career-wise, that's definitely, you know, launched me into the direction where I want to head to. So best thing that could have happened to me, and yeah, now I'm just making the most of it.
Yeah, and since then you've had this huge, phenomenal amount of support on social media. You've got, you know, almost 40,000 people on Facebook following you. How does that feel?
It was pretty overwhelming at the start. Like, to be honest, I started on the show, and before the show, I had 3,000, I think, likes on my fan page. And I think it's nearly 40,000 now, so it's pretty overwhelming, but it's nice to know that I've got that kind of support.
And you were lucky enough to work with will.i.am on the show. What kind of experience was that? It's got to be a second to none experience. Oh,
that was mind-blowing. Like, you know, you only ever watch him on TV and you know, listen to his songs on radio, and to actually see the man in person and you know, try and absorb as much as I could while I was on the show was just, like, amazing.
And how would you say that his influence has sort of influenced your music now?
I think I not just as an artist, but he's a man of many trades, I guess, you know. And but music-wise, I like to produce my own music too, so I've got a little home studio, and I think that working with a producer who's also an artist, I thought I could learn a lot from him. And he's worked with, like, some of the biggest names in, you know, the music today, like even MJ and, you know, all the big names. So, yeah.
And so you've been lucky enough to play, you supported Chingy, is that right?
Yeah, I know. That was pretty cool. Did that in Geelong in Melbourne. So, yeah, it was really cool to meet him, and he's a really cool dude, and, yeah.
What an experience. I mean, I love his music, and he's so old school. Yeah. That would have just been, like, a massive laugh, wouldn't it?
Oh, it was. I couldn't believe that, you know, I had the opportunity to open for him, so, yeah.
But then after that, what are your next steps?
Looking to go to Sri Lanka and do a tour there. So I know I've got a pretty big fan base there. The support has been phenomenal there as well, so I'd love to do that. And then just come back and hibernate, really. Just work on my music and really focus on possibly doing an album.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what would be, like, your dream sort of gig to play at, or maybe a concert, like a huge concert of all your music?
I mean, in Australia, I'd love to do Rod Laver. That'd be awesome, you know, one day. That, if I've done that, I'll be very proud.
We're back. How's that pronunciation going? You're practicing for
yes.
When I ask you later?
Yeah.
Okay. It's nearly there.
Yep.
All right. Good. Because I expect you to know that surname when I come up to it next segment.
Oh.
Yeah.
Don't freak me out,
I know.
Please.
It's a bit scary. Look out. But hey, why don't we head on over? I had the pleasure of going and seeing Mr. Trax. I like
yes.
to call him from Level Up Magazine.
You
now.
Did.
He's doing some wonderful things from Chicago to Melbourne, a lot of culture comparison, and he really loves the connection between Chicago and Melbourne.
Yeah, because so, I've actually heard the cities are quite similar.
Yeah, yeah, I've heard that as well. So, and, you know, he's told me the same, as well as his wife, and they're very, very passionate about it, and they brought this lovely magazine. It's chock-a-block full of absolutely everything from fashion to any
yeah.
culture in and around the parts of
well,
Chicago.
Well, you've ruined
Melbourne.
It, because no one needs to watch the interview now.
Oh, they do, they do, because when they watch it, they're going to be blown away.
All right, blown away.
Blown away.
All right, we'll stick around for that.
All right, as you can probably hear, the girls are getting a little bit excited behind us because here I am joined with Mr. Trax. How are you, mate?
I'm good, man. What about yourself?
Yeah, not too bad, not too bad. Now, tell us, you're an entrepreneur and you started up your very own magazine, Level Up Magazine.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us about it. Take us through the journey. How did this evolve?
Well, it was involved back in 2008 in Chicago when I was in college, actually, studying, like, music production. Then since I've been, you know, at Columbia College, I was around the industry a lot, and,
mm-hmm.
you know, I had the fashion thing. Then it just prospered from there. Just use my knowledge and just tackle all the elements and move forward from there and just highlighting, you know, key elements of, you know, real good quality music where underground is mainstream. That's like our logo
yep.
and motto. So, and my wife, Bridges Trax, she's the editor in chief. So she can talk
hey.
A little bit more about it, you know, as well. So,
wow. So it's actually, it's a team effort as well, isn't it?
Yes, yeah.
Gas to be, man.
It's a team, yeah. So yeah. basically Level Up Magazine is a premium urban publication that is online and in print. And now with this project, Melbourne, Chicago, we are on the international platform in Melbourne, And now all the models who are participating are on an international platform in the US. But when we definitely, when we started out in 2008, it was an idea that has grown tremendously throughout the years. And my role, Level Up Magazine, is as the editor, I help find talent, and I also write and just work extensively with coming up with basically everything for the editorial calendars. And I'm an English major, so we were both at uni or in college at the same time when Mr. Trex kind of came up with this whole entire project, and now we're here, so welcome.
Yeah, welcome. Well, welcome to you guys, you know, for being in Melbourne. And what about the connection, obviously, Chicago to Melbourne, particularly fashion-wise? How do you find the trends? You know, who's ahead of who? What's going on these days? Because it is obviously social media. Everyone's in tune these days. What's happening there?
Well, I think it's really unique with Chicago and Melbourne. That's why we want to highlight this special edition. So you will find that information in that next issue. Oh. So you will see the different styles and different seasons and stuff like that. It's kind of interesting. You know, actually see the different styles here in Melbourne. When I first started shooting here, it's just like, wow, you know. But, you know, H&M just started coming here and stuff like that, so we're starting to see a lot of more influence on that end as well. But I wouldn't say a competition. I just feel like it's a unique world, you know what I mean? So just to see different sides of the world is a great embracement, you know.
One thing that I have noticed personally, experiencing working with people in Chicago and in Melbourne here, is just everything is fast-paced. I mean, coming from a big city, everything is fast-paced, and there's definitely some really, really beautiful, beautiful talent here in Melbourne. It is just, it's amazing. And in Chicago, you know, it's always a grind season in Chicago. So it's like we're always busy, especially back home, just connecting because there's so many people from everywhere, not even just Chicago, who reach out. And and we're learning that the industry is pretty similar here. Like once you've gone to one networking event and you've met people, you end up seeing them again. And then it just keeps rolling and continuing.
Like a snowball, like in Chicago.
Like a snowball effect. Like a snowball effect. So yeah, definitely, I feel like the models here have very unique looks, and they're also in a good place because they can work with some of the best agencies and just really connect. I've seen really, really good portfolios. So I'm really loving it. I'm really loving the models' portfolios, and it's just really beautiful. As far as music, I'm always going to be team team Chicago with the music. At the moment, just because I feel like
Chicago is the industry right now.
The edgy urban, like Chicago has it in the music industry. Like we have it. Like it's there. It's like
a chance to rap
the shit. It's the best. So just from Chicago and just with the fashion here, I just really feel it's going to be a beautiful connection with Melbourne and Chicago. And we're definitely headed for creating more distribution outlets here in Melbourne with the Melbourne Chicago Fashion Edition, and also expanding our reach in Chicago as well. So really creating that conversation between Melbourne and Chicago and connecting talents, you know, worldwide. So that's definitely the plan.
Excellent, excellent. So the music scene still taking your preference over there in Chicago. Have you had a chance to check out the music here in Melbourne?
Yes, we interviewed, if you go on our site, we did interview couple of artists here in Melbourne and Sydney as well.
Yep.
So Lost Keys was one of them.
Barrow
was one of them as well.
And Charlie Threads. So big shout out to you three.
And they was turning up. We happened to see them at what festival was that? I think Melbourne
Music
Music Fest.
Yep.
Yeah,
Music
we was there.
League,
we saw them live performed. Yeah. So it's good. It's different hip hop, man. It's crazy.
It's
Yeah. There's a lot of different genres in and around Melbourne. It's a very very culture-based, so fantastic. All right, well, and what about, on a personal note, what do you think of Melbourne yourself? Because obviously you've been here a little while. How are you finding Melbourne as a place to base yourself?
Well, I'm a city girl, and I like the fact that there's lots of modes of transportation, so I think that's really lovely. The weather at the moment is very good as well, because it's a snowball, a snow effect in Chicago right now. Yeah. So I love the weather, and the people are very, very friendly, and it's just been really fun meeting people and connecting. So personally, I do like it. I do miss home though, because no place is ever like home.
No, never.
But it is lovely, and we've gotten lots of love and support here in Melbourne. So I think Australia is amazing, and we can't wait to explore more of it.
Yeah. All right. So what'd you think about Level Up Magazine?
I thought it was awesome. I mean, I love all things fashion and culture and entertainment and things like that. So, yeah, now I just want to go to Chicago.
You just want to go to Chicago? Ditch Melbourne, ditch Australia, go to Chicago.
And if it was good for anything, then that's at least they've got one extra person visiting.
Well, that's very true. That's very true. I mean, maybe we'll just do a bit of a culture swap. You go to Chicago, they come to Melbourne.
Yeah.
It's like a bit of an exchange program.
Yeah. Could someone pay for it?
Yeah. And then we'll do it with the magazine. Why don't we tie that in?
Okay.
That's a great idea.
I don't know if this is going
to
happen.
Well, I'm going to get on to Mr. Tracks and say, hey, how about we do this exchange program? Let's do it.
Sounds good.
Excellent. Well, we're going to go to a break, but when we come back, we're going to find out exactly what Ash's surname is. Are you prepared? Are you ready?
I think I am.
Okay. All right. Back in those golden days, you left me all the hills, and so I don't go home. Damn it. Back in those golden days, you left me all the hills, and so I don't go home. Damn it. I got my thrill. All right, we're back.
We are.
How are you feeling?
Good.
You're not a little bit nervous at all? Yeah.
A bit nervous.
Why would you be nervous?
I don't know. Maybe because I can't say difficult last names.
Oh, okay. Okay. Well, my surname's very easy. Do you want to try that?
Yeah.
Yeah? You ready?
Yeah.
N-E-S-S.
Ness?
Oh, well done. All right. She's got one under the belt. Okay.
But I want to hear Ash and his
and his comedy.
His comedy.
Because he's brilliant. He's been on the show before, guys. So most of you guys probably do. And we'll recognise him once he starts. But what's his surname?
Ash Filsimay.
Oh, round of applause. Mm-hmm. Round of applause.
Did you see that?
I loved it.
Mum would be proud.
And the diction that you had in there was perfect.
I think so. But let's go and check out what Ash has got to say.
Hey, I want your rap music, man.
Well, they say that laughter is the best medicine, don't they? And this guy here, he's been on a mission to cure everyone across the world. It's comedian Ashley Filsimay.
That's right, folks. I'm here to heal the world. Right now, if you start laughing, you are healed. Did you know laughter is medicine? Did you know that you can laugh your way out of an acute cold? Did you know that? Did you know that you can laugh your way out of a cold? Like, you can chuckle, like, you know, you could chuckle over a cold.
Not sure where to go with that, but yeah, but it's great to have you on the show.
Thanks a lot, man. Appreciate it.
This is your second appearance on Media Strikes Back.
Yes, it is. I'm media striking back again.
Tell me something about yourself. I've done a little bit of stalking, a little bit of Googling on you, actually.
Sure.
And born in Haiti.
Yeah.
Is that correct?
Actually, I was raised in Haiti. I was just born in New York, but I was raised in Haiti. Yeah.
What's brought you to Australia to do comedy?
I came out here a while ago. And I actually was doing here during the festival, during 2010, 2011. I started really falling in love with the country. And then I decided to come here and be here because it was a very warm feeling here, like a very home feeling, you know? And I'm also, my fiance is here too, so.
This whole award thing is crazy, man. How come weird people always seem to have followers, right? Think about it, Bin Laden, David Koresh, Tom Cruise, always have followers, man. Now, come here, my son. I am Bin Laden. Do you want to be in paradise? You do? Kill yourself. What the fuck? When you die, you're going to have 72 virgins in paradise. Guys, 72 virgins. Who wants that shit? That's too much work. Fuck that. You give me 72 hoes, now we're talking some experience, man. What am I going to do with 72 virgins? Ow, ow, next. Ow, ow, next. That's my paradise. You give me a hoe. Osama, your mama, bitch. Did that orgasm? For a rocket ship. Let's say you do have 72 birds, right? Let's say you do, and you go ahead and you de-virginize them. It is not a big deal. Wanna know why? Because they're still there. They do not disappear. So now, you gotta take care of them. Right? There's a responsibility times 72, Jack. And it's 72 ladies you have to respond to every day. You call them late from work, and 72, where you been? 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 Where you been?
Fantastic. And Melbourne's been your, I mean, you perform quite regularly at the Comics Lounge. That's like a bit of a base for you.
That's right. Comics Lounge, 26 Earl Street, North Melbourne.
Come on down. Free tickets?
Yeah, well.
Comedians start out doing a lot of shows for free.
Yeah, well, yeah. I mean, I've been doing it for 18 years. I didn't get paid until my sixth year of comedy. On my sixth year, I kind of, you know, started getting more and more money and then started touring with Pablo Francisco for a while and just, you know, it started taking off. And I can't remember the last, I mean, I haven't done a free show in a long time, but except for charities and benefits, I'm always down to do that, you know, because, you know, it doesn't pay, but it pays to do it. So, yeah.
Well, how does a comedian know when they're starting out? You've been doing it for nearly 20 years now, actually. How does a comedian know when they're ready to be paid in terms of, like, you know what? I'm good enough now. How do you give yourself that title?
Someone pays you. You don't. A lot of comics, I can always spot a comedian and a non-comedian. By that, I can always spot an artist and someone who's not an artist, because I do some workshops and I teach them, you know, classes for comedy. And the second they ask me when we get paid, I want to tell them to leave, because it's not even about that. But you do get paid eventually. I mean, you just enjoy what you're doing, and all of a sudden you start getting... I remember my first gig, I got paid $20, and I was ecstatic. I went home and I bought... Well, I won't tell you what I bought, because I don't think it's legal. But yeah,
it was a joke book, actually.
Yeah, so it was.
Anyway, yeah. Now recently you're part of a really big show. It's called the Woggy Christmas.
Yes.
With a couple of friends of mine, Gabriel Rossi,
yes.
George Capagnaras, yes. Who I've worked myself in the same lineup as them, and, yes. And Tahir, I'm a big fan of Tahir. Yes, what was that like working with these three guys?
Oh man, I felt like a brotherhood. It was very nice. It was very cool. They were very, I mean, Tahir, Capagnaras, Gab Rossi. I mean, I couldn't ask for better guys to work with. Everything was just on point, and they were just really. Like really into, like, they're just big kids. They're big kids. That's what they are, and they enjoy what they do. There's no ego. There's no I'm better than. There was none of that going around, man. I just wish it would have been just a year long show. I wish I can get that type of atmosphere all the time. It was just, if I could do it again, I would do it again, man. And shout out to Gab Rossi, Joe Avati, Tahir and Capriones, because Joe Avati is actually the one that
producer. Yeah.
Yeah, and he was there at some shows, and it was probably the biggest show I've done so far.
Where can people catch you here in Melbourne? I know you're at the Comics Lounge. Is there anywhere else around the traps that you're performing, or the base is there? And
absolutely. I have my own room in Brunswick Hotel called The Brunny. We do it fortnightly, which is every other Monday. You guys call it fortnightly?
Yeah.
Every other Monday is my own room. It's for comics who want to come out, try new material, and people who want to get somewhere and get started. It's a very, very supportive room. Come check it out. You can catch me on here on Meter Strikes Back. I'll be on here. Yeah, check that out. You're checking it out right now.
And on Facebook, he's got like 4 billion followers and likes.
That's
so
right. Yeah, I do. I have a lot of likes on Facebook. Oh, shucks.
Oh, come on, man. Stop. Hey, should we get that ice cream?
Yeah, we should, man. Let's get some ice cream, man.
Yeah, thanks, mate.
All right, man. Cool, man.
All right, back to you.
Jules.
He's funny.
He is very funny.
He really gets me every time.
He does. I'm pretty sure that if I went along to one of his comedy shows, I would have sore ribs for the rest of the week.
You should be a comedian.
I should. But I'm trying. This is my little get-to. Yeah,
this is the in to the comedy.
It is. It certainly is. But the sad thing is, Jules, although this was an absolute pleasure having you on for your first couch episode, it's the
done.
End. It's
sober.
Done and dusted. Well, guys, you can come and see us on our website, www.mediastrikes.com, where you'll find all the information from tonight and all of our past episodes. You might even find out some information about what's coming up, some giveaways, prizes. It's all there.
Prizes?
Yeah, there's always prizes. You've got to go to our website. Check it out.
Cool.
And don't forget to hit all the avenues on social media. So that's Facebook, Twitter, you name it. I think we probably even have a MySpace account from years ago somewhere there. Who knows? But look, follow us. And you're going to find out absolutely everything. That's how you're going to stay in tune. But until next week.
See you next time.
Bye.